Again, we will consider the same triangle here. This is AX1, Y1, BX2, Y2, CX3, Y3. Now, we observe two important points here. This is in center. If you draw a perpendicular, 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 now all these are equal in length. So, you are able to draw one, a circle touching all the three sides of the triangle internally. Now, since it is a circle, all three are nothing but radii, we can get a conclusion that in center is equidistant from sides of a triangle. So, in center is equidistant from sides of a triangle, sides of a triangle. Here we can get one more result. Suppose you take a triangle like this, and these three are the three points A comma B comma C. Now we know that circumcenter, this distance, this distance, this distance, let us say this is S. Now because all three distances are SA, SB, SC, if you can draw a circle like this, now a circle passing through all the three vertices of a triangle. Now for this dotted circle, SA, SB, SC are nothing but radii given by capital R. This is called circumcenter. So from this conclusion is circumcenter is equidistant from vertices of a triangle, vertices of a triangle. So the two conclusions are in center is equidistant from the sides of a triangle, whereas circumcenter is equidistant from vertices of a triangle. Now let us come to a new concept called excenter. Now the excenter, again you consider a triangle here like this. Now whatever possibility is there, now extend the lines like this. Now extend lines like this also, you can see very clearly, and like this. Now you are able to see very clearly one incircle is possible. First of all, this is called internal angular bisector. This is called internal angular bisector. Now you extend like this. Now for A we wrote internal angular bisector. For B and C, this is internal means this is external. Draw external angular bisector like this, and one more like this. Now this is called, this particular point is called the point of concurrence of one internal angular bisector and two external angular bisectors. So this is called excenter, denoted by I1. Excenter opposite to the vertex A. How the circle will be? It will be like this. Approximately the circle will be like this. Now in the same fashion you can draw for this also. For B you draw the internal angular bisector like this, and for C like this, for A like this. You are able to see one more one more circle like this is possible. Now this is called I2, and through C if you can draw like this, now this is one more and this is one more angular bisector. Now this is going to be the one more circle. Now this is I3. You are able to see this is the incenter, this is the incenter, and this is I, this is I, I1, I2, I3. I1 is the excenter opposite to vertex A, I2 is the excenter opposite to vertex B, I3 is the excenter opposite to vertex C. Now excenter opposite to vertex A is given by minus AX1 plus BX2 plus CX3 divided by minus A plus B plus C comma minus AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 by minus A plus B plus C. As usual, you know that this is A, this is B, this is C. These are the lengths of the sides of the triangle. Again, you can write X center opposite to vertex B. So, that is given by this is I1, this is I2 is equal to, now the negative sign will come to B. AX1 minus BX2 plus CX3 divided by A minus B plus C comma AY1 minus BY2 plus CY3 divided by A minus B plus C. Next comes X center opposite to vertex C. Now this is given by I3 is equal to AX1 plus BX2. As you have seen, in I1 X1 is negative, in I2 X2 is negative. Now in I3 X3 is negative divided by A plus B minus C comma AY1 plus BY2 minus CY3 divided by A plus B minus C. So in finding out X center opposite to vertex A, B, C, we will find out using these formulas.